This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hello there, and welcome to episode 19. In this episode, we're going to talk about transformations. Now, a transformation effectively modifies the shape and the position of a graph. This time, we're going to talk about how to do transformations with an absolute value function. Let's have a look. All right, so I've given you the graph for this function. F of x equals absolute value of x. It looks kind of like the letter V. It is centered on 0, 0, and the slope is exactly 1. And the slope of the other piece on the left here is exactly negative 1. So you get a perfect V on your graph. Now, our problem today is to find the function for a different graph. Notice it looks kind of similar, but we've done a few things to it, or we've done transformations to it. Before we start, let's write down what those transformations are. Our first transformation is that we have changed the x-coordinate of the vertex. It was 0, now it's negative 3. That means we have moved it to the left by 3 points. But that's not it. We've also moved it upward by 2. It was 0, now it's 2. So we've moved it again by 2 upward. And the third thing we did was it was pointing up, now it's pointing down. So we can say that we have inverted it vertically. We've changed the vertical orientation. So we're going to take all three of those things into account in order to figure out what the correct function is. We're going to start from y equals absolute value of x. The first operation we're going to do is to move it left 3. Now, to move it left or right, you are going to put a number inside of those little pipes, inside of those absolute value signs. Now, if your goal is to move it to the left, that number is going to be positive. If your goal is to move it to the right, that number is going to be negative. Well, we're trying to move to the left, so our number should be positive, and the number it should be is 3, because we moved it over by 3 spots. So our function is now y equals absolute value of x, and we're going to add plus 3 inside the pipes. Write it in red. Now on to our second operation. We've moved it upward by 2. If you want to move something up or down, you have to put a number, not in the pipes, but outside the pipes. All right. Now, if our goal is to move it up, the number should be positive. And if our goal is to move it down, the number should be negative. Well, our goal is to move it up by 2, so the number is positive, and the number we use is 2. So our new function is y equals x plus 3 still inside the pipes, and now we're going to put on a plus 2 outside. But we're still not quite finished. Now, onto the third operation. We've inverted it vertically. To invert something vertically, what you do is put a minus sign outside the pipes. So if you want the absolute value function to point upward, you keep it positive or just don't put a sign on there. But if you want to make it point down, you put a negative sign on there. So that changes our function one more time. We will now have y equals, we'll put a negative sign outside the pipes, and then just rewrite our function. Absolute value, x plus 3, close, plus 2. And that's our final function. Y equals negative absolute value x plus 3 plus 2. And that's how you do a transformation on an absolute value function. Next episode, we'll do more transformations with square root functions. We'll see you there.